The recent rains in Luzon caused black sand and piles of garbage to cover the Baywalk along the Manila Bay, where the government recently dumped white dolomite sand to beautify the area. We now have with us Environment Undersecretary Jonas Leones for an update on this issue. Good morning, sir, and thank you for joining us again on the program.
Good morning, Christian, and to your listeners.
I suppose you're seeing the memes going around, ridiculing the Dolomite project at the Manila Bay. They're saying, kapit lang, Dolomite, whenever there's a rain. Mm-hmm. So what's the situation now? May natitira pa ba?
Based on our inspection last Monday, Christian, we observed that the placed dolomite in the beach nourishment are still intact. And we observed that our geo interventions in the beach nourishment are still there and serving the purpose of protecting the placed sand from heavy rains and a strong wave. Although we observe a lot of garbage there, but comparing the situation of garbage in the past, what we saw last Monday is just a few garbage, perhaps because of our geo interventions to trap the garbage coming from Pasig and Parañaque and Cavite. But we have been regularly cleaning up the beach nourishment.
So you're saying the Dolomite project is still intact? Walang nabawas dun sa itinabon?
Oo, kasi sa ngayon merong napatungan ng ano doon, ng black sand. But hindi naman siya na wash out to. Kasi nga malakas talaga yung wave, ano? But what is beautiful there, Christian, no? Kung if you are going to observe the beach area, talagang yung white sand nandoon, yung black dolomite sand, ang medyo na napapatungan lang ng black sand yung mga pampang, yung shoreline. But Christian, ito naman kasi medyo hindi pa tapos yung project natin. We're still waiting yung sa dolomite natin sa source, no? And we have been reminding the DPWH, who is the implementing agency, to fast track the implementation and completion of the beach nourishment para makita na natin yung ganda ng area.
But can this dolomite project withstand subsequent rains that might come? That would come.
Mm-hmm. Alam mo, Christian, itong dolomite kasi hindi naman siya dolomite 100% na binap natin dyan. We have methods. What we did here, Christian, is that first activity we have undertaken here is to dredge. No? Dilinis natin yung lahat ng mga silt dyan. And the void created out because of the dredging, we just placed the clean black sand. So tatlong layer yan, Christian. Merong yung first layer natin na black, and then another layer of black, tibo 1 meter yon. And then yung ating top layer is the dolomite sand. So ngayon sa ngayon, dahil we encountered problem doon sa supply ng dolomite, so only 0.5 meter pa lang yung nandun sa area, and we have to complete the 1 meter thickness of the dolomite there in beach nourishment area.
So because when we look at the photos circulating, it seems like the dolomites are getting washed away into the sea, right, into the bay. But you're saying is that the opposite is happening. Yung black sand from the bay is being washed into the dolomite. Is that true?
Yeah, we have already, DENR has already clarified that. No? Kung makita mo yung black sand dyan, if you're going to visit the area, talagang if you scour the black sand in the shore, nandun yung white talaga sa ilalim, kaya hindi siya na-wash out. So, but this will be addressed so as soon as we complete the project implementation, Christian.
But you said 0.5 meter pa lang naman yung naitatabo na white sand, di ba? So baka naman na-wash away talaga, kaya lumabas yung black na nasa ilalim.
Ang problema ko doon, Christian, hindi talaga namin masabing wash away yon dahil we have interventions. In fact, talaga yung geotubes na nilagay namin doon, talagang ang purpose nun is really to protect the sand. Our priority there is to maintain a high retention of the soil or the sand placed in the beach nourishment area. Nakakontain yun eh.
Sorry, ano yung term na ginamit mo? What was the term that you used?
Geotubes. It is a big plastic bag, okay. Durable plastic bag that we fill the sand. We fill the bag with sand. And then, ito yung nilagay namin sa perimeter So ibig sabihin yung aming sand doon, Christian, it is really contained, and to ensure that kung may mga waves na pumasok doon, talagang naka-enclose yung sand doon sa beach storage.
So it operates like a sandbag or a parang wall?
Parang wall, oh. So ibig sabihin yung area doon, nandun yung nakapaligid yun. So it is really impossible to encounter tayo ng washing away of the sand dahil nakakulong nga siya, nakakontain siya doon. Okay. And perhaps, siguro pag tagal-tagal dahil nakikita natin medyo nagbubog pa yung mga sand because palalagay lang naman kasi yan, hindi pa siya stable doon. But perhaps pag tumagal-tagal na yung project, we will be seeing that naka-stable na doon yung mga sand na nilagay natin.
But in the long term, once the project is completed, what will be the measures that will be put in place to make sure that they won't get washed away?
Yeah, pero pa, like for example, in addition to the DO tubes that we placed, no, the DPWH, as we have been informed, no, to ensure that the beach will be there, no, and it will not be destroyed by strong current, they plan to put a breakwater in that area, siguro mga malayo lang sa beach. Ang purpose din nun, similar to the geotube, to caution the strong wave or strong current that yung papalo dun sa beach area.
Okay. I'd also like to see clarification from you because you were quoted as saying in certain media reports that 10% of the dolomites have been washed away. So you clarified that it's not true.
Yeah, we clarified. Because,
okay. How about the second?
Because when I was interviewed, dun sa, parang ambush interview on Christian. So we did clarify it during our statement that what we are referring to, kasi ang tanong doon na Christian, ilang anong area na yung natatabunan, parang doon yung dating natin. So we want to clarify that yung 10% pertains doon sa nakoveran, supposed to be nakoveran ng black sand doon sa shoreline.
So 10% pa lang ito nakikita namin sa photos?
Actually, hindi naman siya accurate kasi tinanong natin mga estimate. So we have yet to measure kung talagang if we want to really determine how yung extent ng na-cover na dolomite yan. So we need to measure it. But the question is approximately in your personal view. So 10% lang yan.
How about the other statement? Are you actually advocating this, yung tabunan ng black sand, yung tubig, para yun naman yung mawawash into?
parang imposible yun. So ang ginawa natin doon, talagang kasi hindi pa nga tapos yung shoreline. So hindi tatabunan yun, ayusin yung shoreline. And then the shoreline will, of course, then kumuwata rin yung tubig. Pero parang technically, hindi feasible yung lalagyan mo ng black sand yung water. Siguro, sa bilis ng mga interview na ganyan, hindi mo nag-review masyado yung interview. That's the reason why we clarified it. No? Ang pinaka-direction natin dyan is once we have completed, Christian, the placing of the dolomite sand, perhaps makikita natin na talagang magiging stable na yung black sand and at the same time yung dolomite in the beach area.
So when are you expected to complete the entire project?
For the beach nourishment project, the secretary made mention that we are committing to the public that by the year end we can finish all the our activities in the Baywalk, because it is not the rehabilitation, Christian, does not focus only on the Baywalk. We have a lot of activities also component of the project. We have addressing the different tributaries, different river systems, and the settlement in order to address yung problem just Manila Bay. But for the purpose of really rehabilitating the Baywalk, Christian, we plan to complete all activities there within the year, which includes the improvement of the water quality in the Baywalk. Mm-hmm. We will be installing some infrastructure there to make it a good tourism area for the public. And hopefully, the beach nourishment area will be completed so that the people can also enjoy the white beach and to view the sunset in the afternoon there, Christian.
Yeah, because you also need to understand why people are very concerned. Of course, the heckling will always be part of the discussion. But we're talking here of big money, 28 million pesos, just for the Dolomite project. No, we're not even talking about the entire project. That's why people are asking at this stage, how do you respond to this? Why don't you just admit that this was a mistake, that this was a bad proposition to begin with?
I don't want to say that this is a mistake. I say it's too early to determine whether there is a wrong move on our part. What we are focusing now, Christian, is that the fact still remains that there is a mandamus case issued by the Supreme Court ordering all agencies to clean up Manila Bay. And there is also a directive from the President, you know, to fast-track the rehabilitation of Manila Bay. So since 2008, Christian, when the mandamus case or mandamus order was issued by the Supreme Court, I think there was no milestone or big strides in really to show that there was a action on the part of the government to really clean Manila Bay. It's only now under this administration of President Duterte that we can see something that is happening to really rehabilitate Manila Bay. In fact, Christian, the budget in 2019 that we use here, that we utilize here in the project, isn't really part of the regular appropriation. It came from the President's budget geared towards really to really rehabilitate Manila Bay. And yun lang mong focus muna namin. So whether we are wrong, maybe history will judge us. But Christian, if I can mention this, no? If you look at some models abroad, no, like for example in Miami, Singapore, Sentosa, they're using also beach nourishment strategy to make sure that their beach are beautiful. So based on sa kanilang analysis, Christian, yung cost ng regular beach nourishment nila at saka yung kanilang nakukuhang revenue because of the tourism sector, yung revenue na kukuha nila doon far outweighs the cost of really rehab yung beach tourism.
Okay,
so yun ang gusto namin mangyari dito, Christian.
Yung cost-benefit analysis. Of course, that's true. To be fair to you, to the administration, finally we're seeing certain concrete projects to implement the mandamus order by the Supreme Court. But again, we don't want money wasted still, di ba?
Yeah.
The concern
that's
is that this has to be done properly.
Yes, Christian, kaya nga maganda rito because you are there in the media, there was nandiyan yung academe, nandiyan yung civil society, and then criticizing the project. Because sa amin, mas maganda to eh. Kasi at least we value their comments and maybe we are evaluating all these comments from our critics and we see whether there are some adjustments in our strategy that can be incorporated or can be used. No? But ang tingin kasi namin dito, Christian, may mga limitation kasi when we implement the projects, we consider the resources, we consider the timelines. So hindi naman po pwede na talagang forever we will be planning and incorporating all the comments. No? But I think maganda ito. At least nakikita ng mga tao, they are aware that there is a project there and they need to comment. Ito yung nagiging guide namin to make sure that whatever resources given to us, talagang we use it judiciously and properly in accordance with the COA.
Okay, Undersecretary Jonas Leones, thank you for joining us, sir.
Thank you, Christian. Thank you for inviting me.